Good afternoon, sir.
How do you feel? You're better prepared now?
Yes, sir. Much better prepared, sir.
Tell me this. I think I don't know whether I asked last time. Smile. You are a founder of that?
Yes, sir. Founder, and I was also the ex-president of this NGO, sir.
The Smile which we know. There's only one Smile NGO? Or that?
No, sir. This is basically based on Pondicherry in Tamil Nadu, sir. Smile Foundations. The other Smile Foundation also is based on Delhi. This is a different Smile Foundation.
Same name. How can we?
Sir, initially when we started, we didn't know about this other NGOs. The same name exists because we started at the college level. And only then after we opened our website and all, we realized that there is another Smile Foundation, sir.
Absolutely, there is no change, difference.
Sir, that is Smile Foundation. We have an extra, yes, sir, Smile Foundations for us.
And you are already there in service, no?
No, sir. I didn't join the service.
Didn't join. So, no chance to join that.
No, sir.
Okay. Now you tell me, I was reading some news about this Ivermectin, that drug.
Yes, sir.
COVID.
It was based on some research from Australia. Now it is no longer valid. But other medicines could be drugs more, which our AIIMS and ICMR failing not required.
Sir, the major drugs which has been now out of the standard operating protocol is that ivermectin, azithromycin and doxycycline, sir. But initially during the first wave itself, even hydroxychloroquine was removed, sir. I think this is a protocol which has been evolving over time because we are still not very clear of what works and what doesn't work.
And everybody took a lot of zinc also.
Yes.
And that is also not required.
Sir, zinc is basically a supplementary addition, sir. So since it's a nutritional supplement, there is no standard procedure on it, sir.
There is no harm in taking that.
Yes, sir. The major thing is that we need to take a course of 10 to 14 days and not more than that, sir. That is the guidelines right now, sir.
So, what is the drug now to be taken? Nothing?
Sir, it's based on whether you are a mild, or moderate or severe case, sir. Mm. In the mild cases, even now, only home remedies are recommended, sir. Maybe in case if you have fever, we can go with paracetamol. And if you have stuffy nose, you can go with levocetirizine or D-Cold tablets.
That's all. So the normal ones.
That's a normal one, sir.
Nothing.
Nothing for the mild cases, sir.
People wasted tons of rupees on that.
Yes, sir. Mm.
You know, this Tamil Nadu High Court has made very interesting observation in some case. You know that? Could I explain?
So, the recent one based on the reduction in the number of MPs, that one, sir?
Yes. Tell me something about it. Very interesting.
Sir, during the year 1962, Tamil Nadu had a representation of around 41 MPs in Lok Sabha, sir. But because...
Reduced.
Yes, sir. After when we...
No. My question is whether High Court can make this type of observations.
Sir, being a judicial body, it can definitely make observations. But the thing is, whether to enforce or not, it depends.
But this will open Pandora's box. The South Indian states will go for that.
Sir, these demands have been already there for the past 20 years, sir. And that is why we have not moved from 1971 census even now, sir.
And how they can assess that he is contributing 200 crore rupees for the development of a state? I feel he is spoiling 200 crore rupees. In what way is contributing?
Sir, High Court's observation was based on the notional value, sir. Mm. But being a legislator from a state, definitely there will be a lot of representation of the people's voices in the Parliament of India. Mm. And more than just the representation, it also talks about the needs of Tamil Nadu per se or the other southern states per se. Only then the voice will be heard in the Parliament, sir. So that is why this notional value was attached.
He gave example of that Atal Bihari Vajpayee Government College.
Yes, sir.
This Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. What is latest on that? Have they developed something? Some transport plane?
Sir, I'm sorry, sir. I'm not aware of it, sir.
This from Afghanistan, some people were carrying something on their head. What was that?
So recently, Sikh people, they carried the Guru Granth Sahib, sir, recently. Mm.
So what is the significance of that?
Sir, it is their holy book, which they considered as the 11th and the eternal guru. And that is why they had to give a lot of protection and bring it on their head.
So those are originals?
Yes, sir. Originals, sir. Mm-hmm.
Originals 3 out of 6?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Asa Bhonsle is having some restaurant in Birmingham. Heard about that?
No, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Religious fundamentalism. There was some news from South.
Sir, there has been an increasing number of religious fundamentalism which has been spread through social media, especially in the southern states. And there are a lot of...
This Kerala chief minister told something about this, giving some example.
Sir, I'm not exactly sure of what he said, sir. But it was related to a lot of people in Kerala who are migrating, are becoming sympathizers for this extremism, sir. Based on that, sir.
He gave example of Afghanistan, what is happening in Afghanistan.
Sir, I'm sorry, sir. I'm not aware of it, sir.
Now this, because of COVID, we have lost, children have lost 1 year schooling. Know something about that? How many and how, what could be the number in India who have lost 1 year? Percentage wise, how many children don't have access to internet?
Sir, recently there was a parliamentary committee report also which said that almost 77% of the children had missed more than 1 year of schooling. Mm-hmm. And it was also astonishing that the digital divide was more than what we expected, sir. Based on other data from telecommunication departments, we had that 55% are only out of digital communications. But based on this report, we realized that 77% of the children were out of this digital divide, sir.
RERA, you know about RERA?
Yes, sir.
It's now 3 years or so, I think. And this act came more than 3 years. Is it functioning well? Objectives are being achieved?
Sir, I'm really not sure about what is happening on the ground, sir. But right now, most of the builders are following as per the RERA guidelines. And most of the buildings in and around the cities are coming under the GST network also right now, sir. So I'm not exactly sure how it is functional, sir.
Happiness. What is happiness to you?
Sir, happiness is something when what we do, what we think and what we act are all in congruence, sir.
Are you happy a person? What gives you happiness?
Sir, I think happiness is something which should not be defined, sir. When we do not define happiness itself, will make us much more happier person, I feel, sir.
Okay. Recently, a cabinet minister was arrested in Maharashtra. Why was he arrested?
He was arrested based on sedition charges because his speech was considered to be incitement to an offence. Based on that, he was arrested, sir.
Do you think it was correct?
Sir, after the speech, there was also violence which was seen in the Maharashtra region. I think whether a common citizen or a legislator, I think they should be brought under the same rule of law. And only with the judicial investigations, we will come to know whether the section was properly implemented, sir. But wherever there is an incitement of offence, based on the Golaknath guidelines, I think he has to be taken into custody, sir.
Does it amount to attacking the opposition?
Sir, definitely that angle also has to be thought, sir. But in this case, there was definitely an incitement to offence. That is why he was arrested, sir.
Can you tell me something about Puducherry?
Sir, Puducherry is a union territory which has four subordinate territories within it. It's a very famous French colony, and it also has a French heritage even surviving till now. It is one of the places in the entire world where it hosts a sub-city called Auroville, which is known as a city of humanity, where this is beyond even cultures, religion, race, caste, countries. It's beyond all these borders. It's a very famous tourist destination. And it also has very good social indicators, especially in education, women employment, etc. Sir.
Puducherry or Auroville?
Puducherry, sir. Mm-hmm.
So Auroville was set up by whom?
Sir, it's based on the vision of Sri Aurobindo. It was set up by the mother, sir, Mira Alfasa.
Okay. Can you name me some principles that were given by Sri Aurobindo? Principles or general teachings?
So the major principle was based on internal yoga, sir. What he said was it's not just about external fitness which is important. There is also need for spiritual awakening. And this spiritual awakening can be even without religion. That was his main concept, sir. And he mainly gave importance for peace of mind and happiness, sir.
Puducherry culturally is very close to Tamil Nadu. That's, I think, almost the same only. So don't you think the UT status should be dissolved and it should be merged into Tamil Nadu? Why is there a need for separate UT status?
Sir, the major reason why this special status has been maintained is dates back to the 1954 agreement with the Indo-French agreement, which said that there will be a special status which will be given for this union territory, sir. And that is why we are still following it. And culturally, slight differences are there. But in case in future, if the government decides, like for administrative convenience, we do not give such a privileged status for a small territory, I think it can be revoked also, sir. But otherwise, when we take in the practical aspects, Puducherry has been considered as a pilot city for all the central government projects, sir. Especially when we take these projects like Smart City Mission, Puducherry was tried as a pilot city. And that is why it becomes very important to have such a place in the Union Territory map also, sir.
You haven't opted for Pondicherry Civil Services. Why?
Sir, I wanted to work in a place especially directly into the Indian Administrative Services, whereby I can directly contribute to the various departments, and that it will be much more diverse work than the Puducherry Civil Services.
Some option could have been given. Maybe the first option would have been IAS, but maybe, you know, 7th, 8th, 5th, 6th, anything.
Sir, I thought it would be preferable either to join Indian Administrative Services or IPS, or rather than I would like to work as a doctor rather than becoming a specialist in a separate department, which will be out of my own domain expertise, sir. That's why I didn't opt it, sir.
You also have a habit of hobby of watching tennis. When is the next Grand Slam, and which Grand Slam is coming up?
Sir, the US Open is scheduled next week, sir. It is starting on last week of August and it will go till the second week of September, sir.
Who is the favorite for this tournament?
Sir, according to me, I think Novak Djokovic will be the favorite for this tournament. Who will be winning his 21st Grand Slam, sir?
What will be your key focus areas as a civil servant?
Sir, my key focus area will be matching the demand and supply which is required for the people wherever I am posted, sir. Especially in the district administration, my key focus and priority areas will be health and education, sir. I think these are the two biggest empowerers for the people. In case if at the higher up the ladder, I would also like to be in the policy making aspects, especially regarding health. I would like to see health not just in isolation, but focus more on the preventive aspects of health and also other aspects of health like sanitation, mental health, etc. also, sir. That will be my focus area, sir.
Last question. What is Jan Aushadhi Kendras and what is the purpose?
Sir, this is a bold step by the government to promote generic medicines so as to reduce the out-of-pocket expenditures among the public in India, sir. Right now, the out-of-pocket expenditure is around 69%, which is extremely high. And in that out-of-pocket expenditure, the majority is caused by the medicines and pharmacy expenditures, sir. So when we promote these Jan Aushadhi Kendras, which is going to give out the generic medicines, the cost will definitely come down. And it will also be a medium through which the government can reduce poverty and this catastrophic health expenditures also, sir.
Is the efficacy of the generic medicines the same?
Sir, in most cases, it's definitely the same, sir. But there are few generic drugs which are under trials and which have to undergo the same standards, which are in the process, sir. But otherwise, whichever generic drugs which have been approved by the government definitely has the same therapeutic index, sir.
Do you consume any organic food? Have you ever enjoyed as a doctor?
Sir, I've heard about organic food, and right now a few products we use organic based foods, sir. Organic foods are those foods which are brought out without any use of chemicals, especially fertilizers and pesticides, sir.
But they need NPK, nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Without this, there would be no growth. All plants they need, and we provide in the form of chemical fertilizers. So how they are fulfilling their these requirements?
Sir, in organic farming, they do not use the chemical fertilizers, but they adopt using organic or the natural based nutrients, sir. Especially, say for example, for the nitrogen content, they use the already used straws and the haze and the old...
There is there are different types of fertilizer. We call them as biofertilizers. So in place of chemical fertilizer, we are using biofertilizer. Now you tell me what are biofertilizers with some examples.
So biofertilizers are the fertilizers which are manufactured using biological processes or the biological organisms themselves, sir. The best known example is the Azolla and the Azotobacter fertilizers.
Some plants are also Sesbania and all that, yes. Higher plants also. Okay, what is this biofortification and how it can help in providing good health to the children? you must have seen some products available in the market. So what is biofortification?
So biofortification is a process by which micronutrients are added into the general food products, whereby it does not alter the taste or it does not alter the shelf life also. At the same time, it serves the common public in a larger scale, sir, for the nutrient deficiency tackling, sir.
Insulin is the product of recombinant DNA technology.
Yes, sir.
Will you call it as biofortification?
No, sir. Biofortification is a process which can be taken by all the individuals without any excessive effects, sir. But insulin has to be treated for only patients who are diabetic only. So it's basically a drug rather than a biofortification
insulin
product.
Insulin is a product of recombinant DNA. Biofortification, you add the things like milk, mother dairy milk.
Yes, sir.
Vitamin A, calcium, all have been added. Even in rice, we have the ferritin genes, which will overcome the anemia problem in the female. Lack of iron. So we have such type of, you know, added products. You tell us, what are the different medicines which are available for controlling high blood pressure? There are two main categories. And everybody is almost at plus 50s taking in India. I can guarantee. So it is a silent killer. So what are the two approaches? One is beta blocker and another is ARBs. Do you know what are the ARBs?
Yes.
Tell me the full form of ARBs.
Sir, they are... Sir, just a minute, sir. I just have to regroup my thoughts. I'm sorry, sir.
I hope you have read Davidson and Harrison thoroughly.
Yes, sir.
For your clearing UPSC.
Without
that, it is difficult.
It is angiotensin receptor blockers.
Very good. Angiotensin receptor blockers. What is the mode of action of this?
Sir, they block the angiotensin 2 receptors, sir. So that this angiotensin 2 receptors are the ones.
Angiotensin, they shrink the vessels.
Yes, sir.
And if we block the receptors, the vessels would be dilated.
Yes, sir.
There would be little shrinkage.
Yes, sir.
And that is the crux of treating stroke and heart diseases.
Yes, sir.
You have to open widely all the vessels which are carrying, you know, blood. Good. So Davidson, Harrison, you are right. Very good. What are third generation antibiotics? With some example. Like septum. Septum is widely the most costliest antibiotic. Will you call it as the third generation?
Sir, basically this generation of antibiotics depends on the classes, sir. It's once when a group of antibiotic is resistant, we go to the next generation. Say, for example, as you told me, in cephalosporins, we have four generations, sir. Yes, sir. This ceftriaxone will come under the third generation, sir. And we have even four generations like cefixim, cefepime, and fifth generation under research like cefaparozole, etc., sir.
So you tell us, my last question, you have a very good knowledge of medical science. You tell me where, in what form, this knowledge you will use in your administration or IAS job. In what form? Because this way otherwise will go all waste.
So the major learning which as a medical doctor I have is that I think I have seen the poorest of the poor in the hospital, sir, where they are totally helpless. I think that experience will be helpful in showing empathy, compassion, and in the policy formation, it can be an inclusive policy formation, sir. Secondly, the knowledge of medicine itself, sir. I think health is one of the base pillars for any economic as well as human development, sir. So all this knowledge can be...
As a DM, do you think you will get any time to study or even to practice your medical job or medical knowledge?
Definitely, sir. I think I always believe in where there is a will, there is a way, sir. I think even in a busy schedule, we can definitely work. And we have examples also like Dr. Samit Sharma in Rajasthan, who was a pioneer introducing generic medicines. And we also have in Kerala also, I forgot the name of the doctor, sir. She practices medicine on Sunday evenings for free of cost, sir. I think I'll also be doing that, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Tell me, you got into Indian Postal and Telecommunication Accounts and Panel. You didn't join?
No, sir.
Why?
So that time I was working in the ordnance factory as a medical officer, sir. I thought because both were group A services, this was more relevant for my profession, sir. So that's why I just quit the services, sir. I didn't join the service, sir.
This, you qualified combined medical services also?
Yes, sir.
That also you resigned, why?
Sir, I was working in the ordnance factory Trichy, sir, but there were only two doctors and it was an extremely busy schedule. So I couldn't focus on my ultimate goal of becoming in joining the administrative services. So that's why I just resigned from there and joined a private entity. And for it helps for my preparation, I felt, sir. So,
but when I go through your card, to me it seems you don't stick to a particular job and particular place. I'm sorry for saying this. For example, you were in Thirunamalai, you gave up that. And then you were in some other place. So, I mean, you see, you had to make up your mind and stick to it. Had you continued as a, you know, combined medical service thing, you would have been something. Or postal, now you are opting for audit and accounts. Earlier you refused to join postal and telecommunication. And now you want to join audit and accounts. I mean, somehow, I don't know. You are not very clear about your own thing or what? Can I say that?
I'm sorry, sir. It's not like that, sir. Basically, I just always my aim was to join the administrative services. I feel that all these changes shows that I'm really perseverant for joining the civil service, administrative services, sir. And secondly, sir, I'm still continuing my job in Thirunamalai. I'm right now working in two places, sir. And that is why I've just mentioned about that, sir. And secondly, what I felt was this audit account services also has huge scope of working in WHO and other health audit systems. That is why I had specifically opted only for the Indian audit account service.
Okay, what is the full form of JIPMER?
Sir, it's Jawaharlal Institute of Postgraduate Medical Education and Research, sir.
Oh, Jawaharlal Institute of Research. And your option is medicine, no?
Yes, sir.
And you opted for foreign service also.
Yes, huh? My third option, sir.
Yeah, third option. Still, tell me first, very basic. What is the difference between ambassador and high commissioner?
Sir, in few countries, there is a different nomenclature, sir. I'm not very sure. I think it's based on the UK nomenclature, sir.
But what? UK?
It's based on the Commonwealth countries have a different nomenclature and the other countries have a different nomenclature, sir.
Very good. Commonwealth means High Commissioner. Yes. You have to be clear about this. Now, suppose you have to describe our foreign policy today. How will you describe it? Do we have a foreign policy?
Definitely India has a foreign policy which has been ever evolving. Mm-hmm. And today's foreign policy will be based on three pillars, I feel, sir. The first pillar will be the becoming a superpower in the future with securing a permanent status in the United Nations. Mm-hmm. Second will be to be the leader of the southern bloc of all the countries in the world. And third thing is that all our foreign policies should be based on our national interests rather than all the other vested interests, sir.
Okay, what is this Look East, Act East policy? What is this?
Sir, during the previous government, we had this Look East policy so as to develop close contact with the South Asian nation countries.
The previous government means government or?
Sir, I'm really not sure, but in the early 2000s, sir, I'm not very sure which government.
Okay. Then, and now?
To give a better push so that we can even grow closer to the South Asian nations, we change this policy into Act East policy so that we directly, it's not just about looking up to them, it's also acting and involving actively with them so that with the increasing economic contacts and also with the increasing strategic ties, I think it will be more beneficial for India, and that is why we move towards this Act East policy. So,
okay, tell me, what is the importance of Myanmar? Should we give a lot of importance to them or we should ignore them?
Sir, definitely being a neighbor, we should give a lot of importance for them. And especially with the refugee crisis and migrants coming into India, it becomes a strategic interest also for India. And with the Chinese angle also, which is going playing in the terms of China-Myanmar cooperations, I think it is one of our major priorities so as to keep a balance between China, Myanmar and India also, sir.
Which are the states in the northeast which are very close to Myanmar?
Sir, there are four states which border Myanmar, sir. First is Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Mizoram and Manipur, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
You heard of Moray?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There is a border at Moray, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.